An estimated 14 million people around the world will be diagnosed with cancer this year. More than 8 million people will die of cancer this year. My name is Ted Trimble, and I do cancer research to reduce these numbers. For the first 20 years of my career, I helped organize national and international clinical trials for women with gynecologic cancers. We saw progress in improving treatment, symptom management, and survivorship for women with ovarian, endometrial, and cervical cancers. At the National Cancer Institute, we know how important it is that researchers around the world collaborate to accelerate progress against cancer. 6 years ago, I helped establish NCI's Center for Global Health. Our focus is strengthening cancer research around the world by building research partnerships and sharing data. We also work to ensure that the results of our joint research are translated into routine public health practice and patient care. I happen to know cancer on a much more personal level, too. My father died of brain cancer, glioblastoma, 1 year after he retired. His youngest brother, my Uncle Bill, died of lung cancer. He had started smoking cigarettes in college before we realized that nicotine was addictive or that smoking was bad for your health. Two of my mother's siblings died of cancer. Her older brother, my Uncle Tom, died of multiple myeloma about 10 years before we developed effective treatment for that disease. Her younger sister, my Aunt Constance, died of complications following debulking surgery for stage 3 ovarian cancer. It's these stories and more that remind me both of how much progress we've made because of cancer research, as well as how much more cancer research I and we must still do. That is why I refuse to stand still.
Share your cancer research story. Use hashtag World Cancer Research Day. U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, National Institutes of Health, National Cancer Institute, cancer.gov, 1-800-4-CANCER. Produced September 2017.